morning, folks. Right, I'm going to a sort of a snowy type landscape. got some oil, plenty of oil. I'm using black here. I don't usually use black. A bit of blue and that. I want to go to a sky that sort of I can see going over. That time of year. Okay, we'll back that up with some yellow ochre. There's a horizon down here. I usually use black, but I've got a lot of it, and I might as well start using some of it. Bit of blue mixed in with it, you can give you a sort of a cold colour. Right, okay, that's a start. Now, clean the brush. And there's a brilliance behind these clouds. So we'll try and capture it, white and yellow ochre, or maybe a touch of, no, there's no red in the sky really, it's a bit of that, but try a little bit of that cane red. Winter sky. Not a bad colour, but it's better with a yellow ochre, I think, and a little white. Now you can hear the tooth on the paper, oil paper. Very good. Very good paper. It's got a membrane at the back of the page, so it stops the oil from going all the way through. Okay, now we'll go back to this grey. Look at this streaky sky, but it's whiter than I've got here. So we'll just see if we can modify that. Right, okay, that'll do. Now, trees. Oh, what have we got here? We've got a few winter trees in the background, but I'm going to put a couple of larger ones in. So let's get a horizon. I'll use one of these worn out brushes. Oh, let's put some oil. Put some more oil. I've had this bottle for at least 2 years, two, 3 years. But it's getting to the bottom now. I'm still struggling to use the Clip Champ movie maker on Windows, because my Windows computer, the hinge split, or one side it split, but I've managed to sort of tape it up a bit so I can use it rather than using the new editor. Yeah, it's a good editor, but at our age it's quite a challenge to use these things. So I've got a bit of this and a bit of that. not winter trees. Let's put that more in the background. I put a little bit of some trunks and things on that before we get into the bigger trees. Look at that up there. Okay, that's that. Now I'm going to use some white spirit. It's very difficult to thin the paint right down so that it flows without white spirit. I expect there's other mediums, but I don't use a lot of this. But I just put a bit in the cap and then knock the cap onto the floor. Right, okay, put that next to it and find an awl. I've got a tiny awl brush here, look at that. Look at that. My friend Sharon sent me that. Ooh. Just give an impression of tree. I can't, unless I rest on the paper, and so I can do it with the marble. So. I'll put some bushes in front of some of this. To cover up the Now, if I put bushes in front of this, it'll give it another dimension before we get into the heavy stuff. Okay, that'll do. Keep that clean. Right, put that there. Right, now we're going to put in some trees so we can put a bit of snow on them. Thank you. I won't put too many trees in it, it'll just overwhelm it, or overwhelm me. Let's put in some tree at the bottom of this. Let's just go back to... Sorry, I'm sort of going to my zone. I start whistling and... Right, okay, we can modify that. So I'll get this rigger. Oh no, I hate this rigger. I paid about 13, 14 pounds for it some years ago, but it's got a chisel end and I hate the chisel end. So let's just use this rigger here. And I'll go over some of this with some of this sort of brushstroke. That's better, the paint's flying now with this. Right, now with this sort of bit of texture right there, that's soaking into the paper, we can get a bit of a meadowy feel to this area here. So plenty of white, a bit of black. this. Of course, that's the burnt sienna. It's a really strong old colour. Get more of that dark in there. A little bit of that. Some shadows, cast shadows coming forward, I think, on some of this. Right, okay, let's go into those trees now using this lovely worn out brush. And we'll have a bit of green. We'll put some snow in there. Some clumps of leaves still on the trees. I need to make one of these a bit bigger. Right, okay, that's all right. Let's get some dull white on the brush. Touch of that. I'll put some trunks back in there, I think. Right, so let's get another little finer brush and we'll go back into it. Don't try to put everything in, otherwise the viewer won't be able to had the pleasure of sorting it out. If you say it all, it leaves nothing for the viewer. I'm going to put some solid white in those trunks. Well, I'm not happy with the balance here, so I'll just get a bit of that. Right, that's a bit better. Now we'll put in some dullish white. On the trunks here, just rough, rough. Just putting some on the on one side of the trunks. So a bit you don't like, just cover them up. Too much in there. All right, let's get some. We've got some plenty of shadow. Let's have some shadows. With some grace, you know. Right, let's put in some texture. Just texturing. The dark. I'm still working, trying to fathom out how to edit. All the editors on the new clip champ seem to appear to be for those that know what they're doing. not the steps, which steps to take on a new video. A bit of greeny stuff, I suppose. Okay, now then, a tricky bit here. Okay, so there's a sort of little figure. It won't show, but if I put it too off, make it too obvious, it'll unbalance it. Well, so we can have a couple of birds in there, I think. Now I'm hoping I'm going to get my glasses back, my new glasses today. But so far I've not heard anything, but it's a bit early. Right, let's put that in a mount. Take all this on. I'm not doing one today. I've had a weekend, but I needed a bit of a rest from painting every day, most days. Put that in there. Put the lid on. Want to evaporate. Make some space. Right, and up there, get the big mount, see what we've got. Maybe a little bit of texture stuff. Oh, look. Do we ever do this? So easy to get carried away. Thank you. Right, okay, I'll do any more than that, I'll ruin it. Right. Okay, well, I hope you like that one, folks. It's just one off the top of my head. I just made it up as I went along. I don't know what else to do with it. It's quite heavy in the foreground, but then it would be because there's lots of shadows and cast shadows. I'm not too displeased with that. Thanks for watching, folks. Let's just get another view further over. There we are. Okay, see you soon. Bye-bye.